JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for March the 9th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce that does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation should not be considered as such and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded once again higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies. It gained the most versus JPY, AUD, NZD, and CHF, while it lost the most ground, it lost some ground only against NOK. The greenback was found virtually unchanged against the pound and the Canadian dollar. Now, the strengthening of the greenback combined with the weakening of the risk-linked currencies Aussie and Kiwi and the weakening of the safe havens yen and franc suggests that once again the main driver in the financial markets was the rise in government bond yields around the globe. Turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that although major EU indices closed in the green, in the US the S&P 500 and Nasdaq traded in negative waters. As for today, market sentiment was soft as well. Although Japan's Nikkei 225 gained 0.99%, China Shanghai Composite, Hong Kong's Hang Seng, and South Korea's KOSPI slid 1.82, 0.04, and 0.67% respectively. Following the passage of the US President Biden's $1.9 trillion relief package through the Senate, the prospect of more government spending and faster economic growth added to fears of a spike in inflation, and that's why bond yields rose further. However, US Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen said that the package would fuel a very strong recovery, but she does not believe that the economy will run too hot due to that. In our view, her comments come in line with Fed Chair Powell's remarks that any spike in inflation in the months to come is likely to prove temporary. For now, any further rise in yields is likely to continue adding pressure to low-yielding currencies like the safe havens yen and franc, but it could also hurt equities and other risk-linked assets like the Aussie and the Kiwi. The main beneficiary from that is the US dollar, which may continue to shine for a while more. Having said all that, though, we stick to our guns that the decline in equities may be a corrective phase. The Fed has clearly said that they expect any spike in inflation to be temporary and that inflation will rise and stay above 2% for some time, the goal for the beginning of normalization in the years after 2023. As a result, we expect fears over high inflation to ease in the foreseeable future, which may allow equities and other risk-linked assets to rebound. As for the dollar, it may come under selling interest on more signs that the Fed is likely to stay accommodative for longer than previously assumed. As for today's events, the calendar appears very light today, with the only data worth mentioning being Eurozone's final GDP for the fourth quarter and the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week. Eurozone's final GDP print is forecast to confirm its second estimate of minus 0.6% quarter over quarter, while no forecast is available for the API report. Tonight, during the Asian morning Wednesday, we have China's CPI and PPI for February. The CPI rate is forecast to have slid to minus 0.4% year over year from minus 0.3%, while the PPI one is anticipated to have rallied to 1.5% year over year from plus 0.3%. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.